Alrighty, so today we're going to be looking at how to use the newly created Buncher Plow Blade. Right here I just have like a 909. You could use whatever cab. I've hooked it up to the C350 Buncher head, but this blade will work with all of the Buncher heads, so the C100 or any of the C350 versions. So first thing you want to do is go to your store. So we're going to go under FDR Logging. Scroll all the way down this long list of fun stuff, and we'll see Buncher Plow Blade. So I didn't make a picture for it because there's really not much to it. So basically what this is, it's just this little piece of black strip that appears. So it's not like a big chunk of machinery or anything. It's just a feature that I want to attach. So we're going to get that. So once that thing spawns, it'll look like this little black strip that falls onto the ground. Now, this thing's light enough, you can just walk up and grab it. So if you walk up to it, you see the little hand, you can just click on that, pick it up, and you want to drag it to the front side of your buncher. So we're going to put the strip just on the ground in front of the buncher here, just like so. And then now we want to hop in our machine. Now, with our buncher head, I'm going to drive ahead a little bit, but all you got to do is lower the buncher head just out in front of it, and you'll see on the bottom, see how it says Q to attach the FDR logging buncher plow. So if you hit Q, it now attaches that little strip just to the bottom there. I wanted to make it really discreet because this is more of a feature for the buncher head as opposed to it being, like an actual implement of itself. Now, unfortunately, I'm not able to put that into the head itself. It has to be attached afterwards in order to have that feature just due to the way that the scripts are built. So once you have that attached in the top left-hand corner, which you probably can't see on my screen, you'll see the option for lowering plow. So in this game, if you want a plow to work properly without advanced scripting, you have to lower the object. So by hitting V, we lower the object. So you by hitting V in the top left corner, if you hit F1, you'll see your help menu. It'll show you lift plow, lower plow as your option. So if you hit V, it'll switch to, it says lift plow, which means that we've now lowered it. The next thing you want to do is you want to hit Y, which allows you to create fields, which is also on that help list. We're still under that plow node, so you want to hit G and then G again so that we're back to the buncher head and we have full control. So if for any reason you can't control the head, like if I hit G, I'm pushing the buttons to close my claw, I can't do anything. I can still rotate the head, but I can't control the claw. If I hit G again, I'm now on the machine and it doesn't work. So you have to be on that actual buncher implement to control it. So now by enabling those features, by hitting V to lower it and then Y to enable it, I now have the ability when I'm pushing my buncher head to actually dig into the ground a bit. Now I wouldn't recommend plowing a full field with this, but what it does is it actually creates this cool little dynamic for when you're bunching. So when I go in to grab a bunch, it actually creates a lot of effects on the ground and it leaves kind of a nasty little spot where you actually bunched, which is cool because it gives you a bit of ground destruction, which if you actually watch real life buncher videos, a lot of the time those guys leave quite a nasty spot on the ground. The other purpose and the main reason I even created this at all was if you're bunching in really heavy terrain with lots of bushes, kind of like what you see here, you now have the ability to just kind of go in and you can scrape out those bushes to destroy any of the ground that you don't want. But it's also just a really sweet effect to be able to go in and do some grabs. It leaves the forest a lot more disturbed after you've gone through and done a clear cut. So you can actually see these little patches all over the place in the ground. So then when you actually go back and look at an area, it looks like you've actually done some damage. You know, you've done a proper clear cut and it looks like you've worked the area. When using the other buncher head without it, it kind of leaves the field look like it looks untouched. The trees will be missing, but the ground looks all exactly the same. But with this guy, like I said, now you have the ability to kind of beat up the ground a little bit. You can get rid of any of those nuisance bushes that you don't want to see. And like I said, overall, it does give you a pretty cool effect when you're going in for your grab. It just adds a little bit of smoke and some dust, and it just makes it kind of feel a little bit more like you're, you know, being a little bit more destructive with the buncher head. And again, as far as realism's concerned, it's, you know, we're never going to be 100% perfect, but it just kind of gives you a little bit of feeling like you're actually doing stuff. Now, this thing does work with the buncher head being on or off. So if your buncher head is off, you can still treat it as if you have a big piece of metal and you're smashing into the ground, ripping up the dirt. Because in real life, if you press into the dirt with a big piece of metal like this, it will rip up the dirt. Now, I'll tell you right now, you're not supposed to use the blade on the front of a buncher to dig holes, because that's a good way to wreck your blade. But in this case, I mean, even if you put the blade down flat and just push forward, it'll still kind of carve up the ground a little bit. And it's just an added effect to kind of give you a little bit of difference in things. Again, if you select that same implement, you can detach it just by hitting Q. It'll drop it onto the ground. And then, you know, if you want to move it, you can put it on a different head or do whatever you want with it. But it's just this little tiny subtle strip. I didn't want to make anything too wild because it's just a feature. And again, it doesn't really affect the actual buncher head itself, but it's really nice if you're getting through this kind of nasty brush. You can go through and just kind of scrape it out. And I'll tell you, it's pretty cool to have this effect on like a whole area after you clear it. It just leaves it kind of, it looks like you actually worked it and it gives it a little bit more of effect. But yeah, so that's a pretty easy thing to install. And I just wanted to give you guys a brief tutorial on how to put it on the head and how to activate it. But you guys can use it or don't. That's up to you. It's just kind of an added cool feature. Alrighty, so we'll catch you guys on the next one. Thanks.